Hey, Gateway. Welcome to Wednesday's edition of The Daily Dose, April 8th, 2020. Today, I want to talk with you about what a life group is. Yesterday, I talked to you the importance of connecting to the power of God and the people of God, and I invited you to be a part of a life group. That's the way we stay connected here at Gateway. And for some of you, you may be thinking, well, what is a life group? I keep hearing about life groups, but what is a life group? Well, if you've been around church life for very long, you'll know that small groups are a vital part of church life. That strategy has not changed through the ages. Jesus was in a small group, and so are we. A small group, and in terms of a life group, is typically this. It usually ranges between 12, and we're opening all the way up to 20 people this time because of the need and because of our venue now being online. We can support more folks that way. They get together weekly to discuss the previous sermon of the week before and to share with one another about life, what's going on in our lives, and to pray for each other. The purpose of a life group is simply to grow you spiritually. Spiritual growth is the goal. And we do that by building relationship with God, to one another, and to His Word. And we do that in life groups. And that's what life groups are. They are set aside for usually a specific amount of time, between 8 to 10 weeks. This time it will be 8 weeks, starting April 19th and all the way in to June. And we want to encourage you to be a part of those. You can go online and simply sign up for a life group if you're not in one. If you've been in one before and left, come on back and sign up for another one. This is the time to join, to be a part and connect here at Gateway. This is so important. Why you would say it was so important? Because actually the best summary that Paul uses for the church, his best explanation and analogy, is the body. And I wanted to read to you out of Romans 12, the importance of staying connected to the body. Paul says this, "For by grace given to me," this is verse 3 in Romans 12, "I say to every one of you, do not think of yourself more highly than you ought, but rather think of yourself in sober judgment and according with the measure of faith God has given you." Paul goes back to, don't forget how important the gospel is, because you couldn't do this on your own. And you can't get all pride filled and say, oh, look, I can do the Christian life without the church. And a lot of people will say that, I don't need the church. But actually, Paul is saying here, don't think of yourself more highly than you ought. At the same time, recognize, he will go on later, to see that God has filled you with His grace, and by faith, you are righteous before Him, and He wants to use you in the body of Christ. He goes on to say, just as each of us, verse 4, has one body with many members, and these members do not all have the same function, so in Christ, we who are many form one body, each member belongs to all the others. So again, the body is the analogy. This is how it gets played out. Paul would use maybe this analogy. Well, I'm gonna use this one. How's that? What happens when you're hungry? Your stomach sends a signal to your brain and tells you that you're hungry. And so that signal then goes to your feet and your hands. Your brain sends another signal, go to the kitchen and open up the fridge. And you go to the fridge, you grab the food. Other signals are sent to your mouth to chew on that food, to swallow that food. And there, the whole body is working together to fulfill the desire of what the stomach is saying. I'm empty and I need food. And the same is true for the body of Christ. In fact, some of us would say, oh man, I don't necessarily need the body of Christ. I can grow just fine without other believers around me. And some people maybe even disband the whole idea of meeting regularly. And what Paul is saying here is we don't operate as independent body parts. Imagine if you walked outside your door today of your home and you saw body parts all over your lawn. That would be a gross, gruesome scene out of like the apocalypse or something like that. But the reality is that many times Christians operate this way, and we expect to hear from God and we ask Him to help us, but God is saying, look, you've disconnected yourself from the body. And He wants us to be connected to the body. Why? Because we all work together for the purpose of fulfilling the mission He's given us and the mission of the church, to be salt and light in our world and to bring the gospel to those who have not heard yet. And so that's the purpose of life groups here at Gateway, is to get you connected, to help you become all that God wants you to be and live the life that He's asking you to live. And we do that in life groups here at Gateway. We encourage you to sign up, go online today, sign up for a life group. If you're not a part of one, please join a life group and do that today. We'll see you next time.